Inshallah, we have Imam Dr. Hamid Slimi, who is here. I know he's rushing from one program to another. And in fact, Sheikh Omar does have to leave. He does have another program to get through. So we want to thank him so very much for being with us today and for sharing those insights. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to bless him and increase him in beneficial knowledge. So without further ado, Imam Dr. Hamid Slimi will speak about the use of astronomical data in Islam for the calendar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على من اصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن جاء من بعدهم واقتفى. My respected elders, brothers, sisters, the time is very short, but alhamdulillah, different scholars will focus on one aspect. I will inshallah speak about hisab. The word hisab scares a lot of people, although it's a Quranic word. And unfortunately, many of us deny the hisab. Muslims have advanced astronomy to a level I do not believe. We would be on the moon in 1969 as human beings, or do what we do today without the Muslim contribution to astronomy. And alhamdulillah, we're honored to have our dear brother, Dr. Khalid Shaukat, who made the effort at a short notice, and he's with us here. Astronomy is the oldest of the natural sciences. It's known this is the oldest natural science. It was used for religion, agriculture, astrology, and mythology, and many other things. For haqq and batil, for good and for bad. Ancient astronomers were able to differentiate between stars. This is what they could do with the naked eye, with their knowledge, including our Muslim scholars. Between stars and planets, as stars remain relatively fixed over the centuries, while planets will move an appreciable amount during a comparatively short time. We were taught as children, when we were children studying under our scholars, they taught us to do hisab for salat. We didn't have the paper with us to tell us when is dhuhr and asr. We used to count footsteps for dhuhr, because dhuhr is the most difficult salat for calculation because of the apex, and we used to calculate for other things. As for the fajr and maghrib, is the sunset and sun and the fajr sadiq and fajr kadib, they teach you these things. But dhuhr and asr, we used to calculate footsteps. In Hanafi, it's double for shadow of an object, and similarly for dhuhr we calculate. So hisab is used for salat. We use it until today. You are using hisab for your five times prayers. Calculation, in fact, all prayer timings were empirically computed. First by way of the shadow criterion, then the sundial, and then, of course, since the advance of technology, by way of the clock which we carry and the watch. Calculation in the Quran, it's funny, some of our Hafiz the Quran say, I didn't know that's calculation. It's in the Quran. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. We quote, there is a Surah Al-An'am, Surah number 6. In Surah Al-An'am, in Surah number 10, Surah Yunus, هو الذي جعل الشمس ضياء والقمر نورا وقدره منازلة. What منازل? منازل لتعلموا عدد السنين والحساب لتعلموا who is he talking to, Sheikh? Talking to me and you? Allah says, I'll read translation for you. I, Allah, want you to know ahead of time the days, the months, the weeks, and all of this. This is the will of Allah, not my will. But why, Allah, we didn't have this for 1400 years, there is something wrong, and I'm going to go over what happened. Allah says, this ayah I read for you, it is He who made the sun to be a shining glory and the moon to be a light of beauty, and measured out stages for it, that you might know you is who? Me, you, all the Muslims, since the time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam until the day of judgment. Otherwise, if this ayah is irrelevant, then we shouldn't use hisab. It's not hisab or not, it's how you use it to bring this shar'i, you know, duty into light and make life easy for Muslims. As Allah Azza wa Jal says, مَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ. He did not put for you in this religion anything of difficulty, of offense. But it looks like every Ramadan we have big haraj in every city. So don't blame Allah, don't blame Rasulullah SAW, blame the Muslims, and blame Muslims who do not want to use ijtihad. And you know ijtihad in Hanafi, Fiqh, Shafi'i, for the Sunnah, Ahlul Sunnah, ijtihad is fundamental. And the enemies of Islam do not want to see us do ijtihad. There is a call actually today in the Muslim world not to adopt ijtihad, because they know in ijtihad the ummah will be revived. The ummah will bring the teachings of Allah and Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to be seen implemented in any time and any place, and of course prove the point that Islam is good for every time and place. But to go on in the ayah, Allah says, no wise did Allah create this but in truth and righteousness. Same ayah in Surah Al-Isra. In Surah Al-Isra number 17. Right in the middle of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هو الذي جعل سورة الإسراء, Allah عز وجل says, وجعلنا الليل والنهار آيتين فمحونا آية الليل وجعلنا آية النهار مبصرة لتبتغوا فضلا من ربكم. Again, ولتعلموا عدد السنين والحساب. Allah says, I want you to know the day and the night ahead of times. What bid'ah? Who said it's bid'ah? Whoever says it's bid'ah does not read the Quran. Now, this is another ayah. Then you know Surah Yasin. لَا الشَّمْسُ يَنْبَغِي لَهَا أَنْ تُدْرِكَ الْقَمَرَ وَلَا اللَّيْلُ سَابِقُ النَّهَارِ كُلٌّ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَحُونَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ بِحُسْبَانِ. And many other ayat in the Quran, explicit and implicit. Allah said حُسْبَان, 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 حِسَاب. So calculation is part of the Quran. I heard a brother not too long ago, he said, a'udhu billah from calculation. He heard something. This is a problem. Calculation is a tool to use for salat, to use for fasting, but a tool, I said, not a goal. Differentiate between a tool and a goal. Now, Allah said that we have Surah Yasin. Well, just to pass time, I have a... read for you the ayah in Arabic, the English, and the sun runs his course for a period determined for him, and is the decree of him, the exalted in might, the unknowing, and the moon we have measured for it mansions to traverse till it returns like the old and withered lower part of dead stock. It is not permitted to the sun to catch up the moon, nor can the night outstrip the day. Each just swims along in its own orbit according to the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, this is Quran. We will come back to the hadith. Calculation in fiqh al-Islami. From the beginning, there has never been a consensus until today on the issue of defining the beginning of the month. There has never been a consensus. We know that since you read the hadith of Ibn Abbas and Muawiyah, hadith Quraib, there are many. There has never been a consensus. Consensus means ijma', which is the third source for legislation. It's actually the first of the secondary sources after Quran and Sunnah. So, how has the ummah coped with all of this? We have something called in fiqh al-hukm al-aghlabi. So long as together we come and do something together, Allah will guide us. As-sawm yawma yasum al-nas. When the people come together and fast, that's what Rasulullah said. So long as the consensus. So scientifically, there has never been a consensus. But from an ummah perspective, unity, there has been a consensus. Because we had a sultan. We had a sultan, means a ruler who represents Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whether he's a khalifa or Muslim, choose a ruler and say this ruler is our amir and he brings this unity. Today we don't have that symbol. We don't have that, so we are lost like sheep without shepherd. This is the situation. The fiqh of the scholars madhahib, they stuck to what they had. Hanafi, Maliki, Hanbali agree that wherever the hilal is seen, Muslims should fast. Wherever, it doesn't matter. And Imam Abu Hanifa, as you know, in Hanafi school, there is something called Al-Fiqh Al-Iftiradi. Supposedly, we have so and so. Their means were limited. Their hisab and calculation was limited with the naked eye, whatever they had. So they wrote books, and those become the source of fiqh for scholars today. But the things have changed, the means have changed. Today, I can talk to people anywhere in the world. I can show them. This lecture can be now seen in India, can be seen in Australia. People have more communication than before. The means have changed. Can I still use the books that were used in the means of those days? I have respect for our scholars. But they told us, you have to use ijtihad. Ijtihad is very important. Ijtihad not in ibadat. Hashalillah. There is no ijtihad in acts of worship. The best worshipper is Rasulullah. Ijtihad in the means. Otherwise, if we say we cannot use calculation, then the tawaf above the Kaaba level cannot be accepted. Many ibadat we do today, we cannot use. The way we pray behind the walls and the way we set up mosques and microphones and speakers, maybe according to some fatwas, you have to see the line, then many things cannot be accepted. So these are called means, not ibadat, the means to the ibadat. So the jumhur, the opinion of the scholars, let's stick to Hanafi here, is wherever the hilal is seen, we should follow. They used to put fire, and I said that many times. It's written in the books. They used to put the fire in Egypt, and then it's same next day in Morocco, they fast. Why? كانوا يوقدون النار على قمم الجبال. Why? They used whatever means possible. And same thing in Khorasan and Sindh and Hind. They used to put those things so people can see the fire. That fire means that the hilal has been seen so and so. Thousands of kilometers. Suyuti mentioned some of that. Many scholars mentioned that the people were so keen to fast together. The Khalifa is in Baghdad and thousands of miles. They had no fax, no phones, no emails, nothing. They wanted to fast the Ummah fast. So that's why the Jumhur and the scholars are here say we fast together. The Shafi'i, they say, لِكُلِّ أُفُقِ الرُّؤْيَةُ. So they use the Matali'. But they never agreed what is Ufuq, what is a region. As you know, in India, India was what is now Pakistan and Bangladesh and India. It's not anymore that, it's different now. There are three countries. How do you define? In North America here, they say, okay, North America, but not San Francisco. Was San Francisco part of North America? We share the same day and same night with them. Well, then we accommodate Caribbean. How about Argentina and Chile and South America? So who has the authority? There is no agreed upon criterion unless we use methods of calculation, astronomy, to say what, how we share night and day. I leave that to brother Dr. Khalid Shaukat to put us to rest when it comes to that issue, because that's not my expertise, it's his expertise. But I am following the Quran and the Sunnah Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Imam Abu Hanifa and these scholars said, when Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam spoke to the Ummah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, "Sumu li ru'yatih wa aftiru li ru'yatih." He did not speak only to the Sahaba. He was speaking to the Ummah until the Day of Judgment. Collectively fast when you see it. Collectively break your fast when, of course, you see it. This khitab to explain qawluhu ta'ala in the Quran, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْ. Shuhud here is not shuhud of hilal. It's agreed upon. Read any tafsir. شهود الوقت لا شهود رؤية الهلال. Allah says, whoever witnesses, not مشاهدة العين ولكن حضور. All the tafsir, all the Bukhari, Muslim, everything agreed upon, even in Shafi'i, everything, that the shahida means here, to be at the time, hadir and wafi hadar, means to be present and in, not in traveling situation. That is shuhud. Not shuhud, you have to see it. If each one of us has to see it, we will never agree. That's the situation. Shahida means here, hudur, not seeing the hilal. Since the Prophet ﷺ, there has never been a huge number, one time one man. It's related in Abi Dawood. He said, he came, Ya Rasulullah, raqad ra'aytu al-hilal. I saw the hilal. He said, atashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. He said, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa Muhammadar Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Qala ya Bilal, addin fi an-nasi liyasumu ghadan. Oh Bilal, make adhan, tomorrow we are going to fast. You may say that's Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah has blessed him with ghaibi knowledge in this, okay? But he's musharriya. He's setting for us. That's why Imam Abu Hanifa had an issue with one witness within certain environment. Others said yes. Some scholars in Hanafi school said one witness, if we know him and this and that and adl and this, we may accept it if we have no other issue. But going back to the calculation, the reason why they did not advance in calculation is because some scholars in the Tabi'i period, and I will show you why that's remained until today, they said, no, we don't use calculation. At that time, calculation was used for astrology, was used for people for not for good purpose, for evil purpose. So astronomy, astrology was a confusion, scholars. So even Sahaba did not like it because it was not a knowledge that was mastered by the Muslims at that time. Later they did. But at that time Muslims said it was a ummah ummiyah. It was illiterate ummah, did not have that knowledge of astronomy. So it was confusing. Astronomy, astrology, it was not used for purpose. They used it for agriculture, for other things. So they didn't have no mastery. Today, astronomy is a totally separate discipline from astrology. Is nothing, is for ignorance. Even in this world, in this society here, you speak of astrology, they think of you as being an evil person, a person who believes in psychic networks and all of this. But if you are a person, astronomy, that you are very good in math, in physics, you have a erudite knowledge of different disciplines, it's not a knowledge that is open for all of us. Even me, I'm struggling to understand a lot of issues. I sometimes go to Dr. Khalid Shaukat, ask, because this is a knowledge that is beyond. We don't learn this in Sharia schools. We learn this little by little based on issues. So, the answer, the reason for this problem is two reasons. It's two issues. Number one, as I said, the answer, understanding of the Quranic verse Shahida. And people said, هل رؤية الهلال أمر تعبدي أم لا? The real problem is, people are saying, is going and looking for Hilal, is that an act of worship? Or it's a means to an act of worship? Scholars, the majority said, no, it is an act of worship. Another minority said, no, it is not. Because when we have a cloud, we don't see the hilal. We actually count 30 days, and then we fast or break the fast of Ramadan. Therefore, it's a means. Had it been an act of worship, Allah would not have exempted us. For acts of worship, you have to make qada. If you don't do ada on time, you have to do qada. Whereas, since it's a means, it can be replaced by counting until it's 30 days. Therefore, it's a means. So, can calculation be a means for this? Now, I would definitely admit that some people misuse calculation. They don't actually start with it, like in Libya and Nigeria. They are using calculation in a very wrong way, with the birth of the moon. That's not what we're talking about. Dr. Khalid Shaukat will explain. We're talking about using knowing when it's born. Now, according to what I read in the Quran, Allah said, it cannot make a mistake. I have put it when the sun and the moon, everything is calculated and measured. If I acquire this knowledge of measurement, if I acquire the knowledge of knowing whether it's going to rain tomorrow or not, whether it's going to be windy or not, does that mean I am, going beyond my knowledge and getting into Allah's knowledge? No. Allah is teaching us, and we are exploring every day from this wealth of knowledge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has. But still, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. I wanted to quote التحرير والتنوير. how, because it's a modern tafsir of a great scholar, Ibn Ashur, but it's in Arabic, basically what he says, these ayats were sent, they might not have sounded relevant to the older generation, but today, this is in mid-50s, 60s, Ibn Ashur is the father, he wrote many books of Usul al-Fiqh and Maqasid. But he's saying here, he said, it's a blessing, look how Islam is relevant for all the times and places. This is in Tahrir al-Tanwir. And he said, look, we are seeing the ayat of Allah now through the Quran. There are many ayat now that we could not see before. Now we are seeing, including the earth is round and it's a globe, it's not a flat thing. All of these things we are seeing, they're making more sense. Now, as I said earlier, Rasulullah, when he spoke to us, he spoke to all of us. I would like to ask you a question. All of you here in the audience, if sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before he died, Allah has given him choice. Would you like to live or you would like to die? He says, Bali Rafiqul A'la. I want asking you a question. If Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now is sitting in Medina, would we fast different days or would we fast with him? Huh? No, how many of you say, no, we would wait for... Just raise your hand. How many of you would follow the day Rasulullah fasts? Jazakumullah khairan. Rasulullah, yes, died physically, but spiritually he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, scholars say, with his sunnah, he's alive. Meaning, by following his sunnah, we're following him. He died, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But... would Rasulullah be happy to see the Muslims split as they are? If Rasulullah was in Medina and the Hilal is seen in Karachi, he will say, Bilal, make adhan for my ummah to fast tomorrow. No doubt. He will call, say, Dr. Khalid Shawkat, what do you have? He say, yes, Rasulullah. He will say, it's confirmed. We have scientific data with this. And we will use that scientific data and we will use the global. Because what? As a proposal, because my time is up. Is, and I have to admit, calculation is not my expertise, but I'm approaching it from in the light of global sight. For the last 6 years, I'm observing. We did the first seminar like 8 years ago, but I am watching global sight, global moon sight, and calculation. They are consistent, and global sight and calculation proves that whenever there is a hilal seen anywhere in the world. And it's confirmed. And I have seen times the Hilal was declared and the calculation said it's wrong, and then they came back later, including Saudi Arabia last year. Was it last year or the year before? When they declared and it was wrong, and then Saudi Arabia they said, you know, we made a mistake. So, proposal is to keep the balance, follow and honor this teaching, and avoid going to the extreme with calculation, because it could become extreme, could be used like in Libya and Nigeria. Just the birth of the moon, use it as a strong tool, because it's not Amr Ta'abudi, it's a means to an Amr Ta'abudi. Okay? And at the same time, follow the majority, follow Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmed, and follow and use a global, inshallah, this way will bring the unity for the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because if we are going to have Eid and Ramadan in 3 different days, that is not the sunnah of Rasulullah, and definitely that is not Islam. So it is not right. And as-sawmu yawma yasumun nas, the only way we can secure that by using every means possible, scientific, and we'll go and look at the hilal. We're proposing, me and Imam Yusuf are willing to go this month of Sha'ban, inshallah. We are going to go, if people don't, we are going to travel to where the hilal is going to be seen. We'll communicate with you, Skype or go to meeting, whatever software, and we will show you. This the Hilal, you're happy, and we're willing to go. Whether you sponsor us or you don't sponsor, we have sponsors already. We are willing to go there and show the Hilal to people so they can feel happy. But inshallah, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite our hearts, and to unite our a'mal, and to bring inshallah some sanity and some unity for this ummah. Jazakumullahu khairan, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.